Yo, what is up everybody? Welcome along to yet another tutorial on the channel. And for this tutorial, we are diving into the Tearout drop, which I made as part of the showcase track for our latest pack, Cobalt Drums. But I thought, you know what? Let's tear down this Tearout drop and show you guys some of the composition. But you know, mostly the sound design and the processing to get it to sound gritty and in your face. I don't know, I thought it'd be something different. Depends how much you guys like it. I might start a Tearout track from scratch series, which I reckon would be pretty cool. Let's hear the drop as a whole and then we'll break down the individual layers. It's very in your face, it's very angry. Start from the top, I guess. Drums. Nothing too noteworthy, apart from the drums sound fucking fantastic because of the Cobalt drums pack. But other than that... extra EQ bump on the snare to give that extra doof sound. Next up is a hi-hat loop, which I converted into triplets, which was a pain in the ass. And a typical classic Tearout pot pan snare sound. Don't want any of the lows, want a shitload of reverb on it to ring out so it sounds like Metallica's Saint Anger. A little bit of Satura to smash it even harder. So drums, super straightforward, super easy. It's the bass, which everyone wants to get to, so we'll get to the bass. As you can see, it's made up of four different layers. The percussion layer, where it gets most of its punch from. The secondary percussion layer, which also kind of adds textures in a way. And the saw wave bass layer. And of course, all that is grouped together with OTT, erosion, punch preset. That's just there for automation and good old sidechain. Let's hear it without the processing. Like, it's hitting heavy, but it's not hitting hard. So OTT to just squish everything together. Notice it's not on 100% and it's got some wacky time values. This is intentional to kind of retain the punch, because if you fully slam OTT, you're gonna lose a little bit of dynamics. Actually, scratch that. You're gonna lose mini dynami. It's squish, it's cohesive. Yet another great plug for OTT. Erosion on some wide noise, add a little bit of spice. Grit, almost. Clean. Just dirty. Like a 2010 UK dubstep comment. And lastly, you punch. Anyway, sub bass, which is just essentially an 808 chopped up. On a couple of the clips, just to add variation and, I don't know, variation. I think when designing your bass rhythm slash pattern, I think you want bass notes in particular to land extra hard on the snare, secondary the kick. So you'll notice the snare is here, and it does the little like hiccup pitch bend right before the snare. So when the snare comes in and the 808 unloads again, then it sounds extra badass, so yeah. I think this last 808 has like a descending pitch. So if you're gonna add some modulation into your Tearout basses, I would do it around the snare and see if you can work into adding extra energy, slam dunk the snare. So yeah, that's 808 honestly. What do we have? Wide noise, just to add extra grit. Percussion layer, let's see this, it's down 12. So that was the original. Kind of like a door shutting explosion sound. Pitched it down 12 and that was it. Went in on the fade outs, some of them are long, some of them are short, so. The 808 is the sub, this is introducing the punch, and the texture in the saw wave is kind of that middle slash high frequency layer. A little bit of processing on this. So it sounds quite different. Resonator on D sharp, which is the key of our drop. I can't hear too much difference, but I think it tightened it up a little bit. Sound toys, a little micro shift to make it a little bit wider. Frequency shifter. little bit of resonance, and to shift it up a bit more since we pitched it down to such a low kind of note. Gate to make it extra snappier. EQA, we didn't want any low end, we want a shitload of high end, because like I said before, it's filling out that high end, the subs occupying the low end. Erosion, grit, and then sidechain. Easy! So this was the original sound. I like the middle bit, so I chopped that up and faded it in and out. So you can see here it's on -7 and then it shifts up an octave. Remember, these sounds are going through like their own dedicated audio effects channel, and then they're getting slammed through like the OTT erosion and compression again. Quite a bit of processing. First things first, didn't want any of that sub or bass, so EQ straight away. Utility, it had an interesting stereo field. I wanted to make it mono, so only the right channel comes in. Sound toys, little micro shift, yet again, making it wide. This was interesting, kind of reverb left. So the top chain is getting some heavy reverb with some side chain. Bottom chain is just passing everything through. So it's a parallel layer of heaps of reverb and a bit of side chain. And then gate. Which doesn't look like it's doing that much, but it's just stopping the reverb from carrying on and on and on. Sidechain, easy. This saw is fairly straightforward to make. Envelope 1, which is our main volume envelope, I've mapped that to sync and level as well. So it's making just a gritty stab sound, both doing 3, and reverb filter as well. Who doesn't love reverb filter? And for the effects, OTT as well. So it's a punchy saw sound. Yeah, and that's all the bass layers together. Another layer which is not super essential, just an analog patch, not the saw bass, which is pitch up a few octaves and with this pitch bend. So instead of doing normal, it's ascending to get to that original note. Oh fuck, what I have it on before? 80 something? And a really weird, you could almost say bandpass EQ filter right there. I don't know. And the rest is just effects to add that background influence, like. Here's the sub bass layer yet again. More erosion, completely stripped of the high end, so it's just like a white noise hiss, OTT. Another EQ, another erosion, another punch. So there's been quite a few OTTs, erosion to add the grit, and compression to add the punch. If you're gonna take anything away to work on your own tear out tracks, this is probably the key ingredients, the special sauce. And this is also just a resample of the main bass. But I wanted to add a point of difference and make it blend into the background and add something random. So a phaser on there and an EQ8 to strip away the low end yet again. Serum, don't know what this channel is actually. It's blended quite hard into the background, so we don't need to really dive into that. And some noises and rises. And yeah, that's essentially it. The other thing is just a growl with a fat rack on it. Which I covered in a few tutorials before, so I won't be covering that. Yeah, and that is that. Hope you guys did enjoy this teardown of a tear out drop. Leave a like if you did enjoy it. I'll catch you guys next Sunday, and peace!